That should go on the trace analysis computer.
And if they're not done, you come deal with Rachel Maddox. She's climbing the walls, not to mention my ass. Take half an hour and put some finishing touches on and bring that blasted art. We need her final payment today to cover up well, damage us get down here. This witch is finding new depths of unpleasantness, and we have to calm her down somehow. And Patrick, if you're not here within the hour, my next call will be to my attorney to instruct him to sue your egotistical irresponsible ass. Understood?
Wow. Doesn't sound much like the host and ally we know. Sounds like Ackerman was on the edge. There's more to be done with that item before we can process it. Hey, do you need a hint? I might be able to help you, but just a heads up. It could count against you in your evaluation. I've updated your case file with a hint.
I wouldn't call it a threat. Patrick was well aware we had a client who was high-strung, and that if that artwork was late, there would be hell to pay. Well, why should I pay it? You know that any business suffers occasional cash flow problems, but really, mentioning I might sue him was my way of lighting a fire under Patrick. He is a fussy perfectionist, and I know he could finish up that painting and even the sculpture by deadline if he just got on with it. I can't think of anything pertinent.
A good idea to be thorough. A good idea to be thorough, but nothing's there. A good idea to be thorough, but nothing's there. Hey, do you need a hint? I might be able to help you, but just a heads up. It could count against you in your evaluation. I've updated your case file with a hint. $60 for an earthbound bird? If art theft was the motivation, why not take the other two birds as well? You'll want a different tool for that. Nice catch. Whoever bagged our bird may have left that print.
Oh, I can tell you it's a disaster. That's one of our most valuable pieces. Hawks are a specialty of Mr. Milton's, and that's a signature work. Any Milton collector would kill to... excuse me. That was an unfortunate burst of hyperbole, but I can say with no exaggeration at all that the perch predator is an expensive item indeed, and I'll be calling my insurance agent as soon as we're done here.
Do you have a photo of that missing statue?
Standard operating procedure in the art game. I'll be glad to get it for you, though I'd appreciate its eventual return. Insurance, you know. Thank you. I can't think.
Those two aren't quite a match. Try to be more sure before you ask me for confirmation. It's all about the details. So, Rachel and her fiancé did kiss and make up tonight. Evidence of sperm shows Mark scored a home run. But look at this. He's got a record with a history of violence. So let's get brass on this bad boy. Those two aren't quite a match. Try to be more sure before you ask me for confirmation. It's all about the details. Those two aren't quite a match. Try to be more sure before you ask me for confirmation. It's all about the details. Those two aren't.
We've tracked every hotel and resort in Vegas. No small task. But we've got them registered at the Romanoff, which is also where their wedding and reception was scheduled. Mark Stock's here to identify his fiancée's body. He says he's eager to help. So let's give him the chance.
We know this is difficult, Mr. Stock. You have our condolences.
You don't have to pretend to feel anything. You didn't know Rachel. Who did this to her?
Well, that's what we're trying to find out, sir. Best we can tell, you were the last. last person to see her alive.
That's not true.
Then who was Mr. Stock?
Her killer, of course. Look, I was only with Rachel another maybe 15 minutes after Ackerman went off to mail a package or something. I had a previous engagement.
And what was that?
My bachelor party at Orgasma.
You mean the strip joint?
Yeah. You think a bachelor party's going down at a library or maybe a church basement? A guy I used to play ball with recommended him to me. Some favor. Far as I'm concerned, Ackerman's a pretentious sleazeball. His word's as good as the paper it isn't written on, if you get me. And this crap with him and this clown Milton, I don't remember when I was ever so frustrated. Listen, I loved Rachel. I worshipped that woman. But she had a temper like a rabid monkey, and when Ackerman and Milton started jerking us around over that work, man, Rachel went off like a bomb. When that girl got mad, she'd get in your face and your eyeballs and teeth'd melt. She wanted her natural beauty preserved forever, displayed at the reception so her family and friends and the whole damn world could see her towering majesty. She insisted that damn artist would show up, and the owner was off on his errand. He left the keys with us in case he wasn't back by 6 so we could lock up for him.
He gave you the keys to the gallery?
Yeah. Rachel and me were supposed to lock up at 6. Ackerman headed out with his package, we had our little fling in back, and then, well, I had a bachelor party to go to. Oh, you know, just had our fun with some cheap champagne. I was supposed to meet the guys downtown at 6 before we headed for Orgasma and the Bash, so it, hell, must have been, what, 5:15? And I had to put pedal to the metal to make it on time, even so. I was a cocky kid, a college star who wound up in the minor leagues. I was too damn dumb to know I should just pay my dues like everybody else, and I made a lot of enemies, throwing my weight and my temper around, and I paid the price for it. That incident got me blacklisted from the league and ended any hope of a major league career. And it was my own damn fault, okay? And since then, hey, man, you're looking at a pacifist.
But maybe you had a relapse, snapped under all this wedding pressure.
After that bust, I started seeing a court-appointed shrink, and I am Mr. Chill now. Nothing gets to me, not even Rachel's temper. I look back on how I used to be, and man, I was not cool. I was a world-class ass. That's not me anymore. I loved Rach, and her family was going to set me up in a sporting goods shop that would have given me a whole new lease on life. You think I would have flushed that down the john like I did my baseball career over an argument about some damn artwork? No way, man. No way. I didn't kill her. I loved her. But there is one situation where I might lose it again. Might have, what'd you say? A relapse.
How's that?
When you catch this bastard, if I get my hands on him, no guarantees, man. No guarantees. Of course. We're on the same team, guys. Find who did this. Find him. I can't tell you more than I know.
Nice, Pat. It's not what I expected, though. This girl spends thousands on artwork for the wedding, but she opts for the junior suite? People and their priorities. good idea to be thorough, but nothing's there. That artwork was definitely due the day of the murder. A good idea to be... A good idea to be thorough, but nothing's there. Wow, the European honeymoon of a lifetime. Not anymore. I might be able to help you, but just a heads up. It could count against you in your evaluation. I've updated your case file with a hint. A good idea to be thorough, but nothing's there. A good idea to be thorough, but nothing's there. Good idea to be A good idea to be thorough, but not. Brass can track down this number for us.
That phone number was to a ticket theater broker. A clerk there remembers Rachel arguing with her about ticket prices. Once you've got enough evidence, I'll hit up a judge.